Slightly Unblended, welcome back to my channel. Today I used the Conspiracy Palette and the Mini Controversy Palette to do this little festive glam, and if you'd like to see how I got it, then just keep on watching. So I'm going to do a few holiday glam looks for Christmas or just festive looking kind of things. So yeah, I'm going to do that today. I'm using the ABH Eye Primer and just getting the lid ready. Okay, now that I have that ready, I was not sure what I wanted to do today, and I kind of wanted to give the Conspiracy and the Mini Controversy palettes another go, because I haven't really used them a whole lot, and where I was wanting to go with this, I realized with the shimmers in this, I couldn't necessarily do exactly what I wanted to do. I could do it, but it wouldn't be how I had it in my head, so I was like, well, I'll try something different before I do that. So I'm really honestly... I was just using two from the Conspiracy palette, but to get this green, I mixed Food Videos with Cancelled. So, that's interesting. To start off, I'm just going to take Morphe M507 brush, and I'm going to just go into Not a Fact to give some depth to the crease. I'm really just trying to pat it on. And I know it's more of a purpley maroon shade, and the light isn't quite picking up how it looks together without making it look a little not necessarily the most Christmassy, but you know. What I'm going to do with a little bit more of the shade is I'm just going to flick it out a little bit. I'm going to take this Farrer brush, and it looks a little dirty, but I cleaned it off and it's just stained. But I'm just going to blend this shade out, because I really just want the main focus to be like in the crease, and it is gonna be needing touched up, but after I add the next shade, I will go through and touch that up. Now I'm just gonna take this Morphe pencil brush and go into Flaming Hot and blend that other shade, the Not a Fact shade. It's gonna look pretty wild for a minute, but it was one of those that I was like, oh no, I've gotta wipe it off. And then it just kinda came together. And this, I'm trying something new. I have a few Profusion palettes and I really like them. And I got their little Christmas thingies. And it was the mini eyes. I got Dazzle and what was the other one? And Twinkle. And they each came with an eye topper. There was a gold one and a silver one. I used gold today. And then mascara. So I decided to try it, and it's kind of sticking. I don't know, but I don't dislike it so far. I think it's so pretty. I'm just gonna blend this shade out with this Elizabeth Mott All Over Shadow Brush and just give her some blend. But this is definitely one of those looks where you're gonna be like, ooh, what the hell is that? Until you get to where you're going with it. And I honestly had no idea where I was going with it, so that was definitely something. And so I'm gonna use the Morphe, I guess this would be a shader brush, and I'm just going to blend it out just a little bit more to diffuse. And then I'm just gonna take that Morphe M507 brush again and go back in the Not a Fact and kind of touch up the crease. with that same Morphe pencil brush, I'm just gonna go back into Flaming Hot and give it just a bit more blend. Now I'm just gonna take this Morphe M421 brush. Yes, M421. I've almost got the number worn off there because I guess from grabbing it so much. But then I'm just gonna take some NYX concealer, what little bit of it I have left, and apply it to the brush and then cut my crease. Okay, so this one has been taken up a little higher. I just kind of want a little, you know, not so great. So I'm just gonna take this ColourPop E10 brush and fix that and then go back in with concealer to clean it up. I'm gonna take a little bit more of Flamin' Hot and fix that as well, just to blend it. Okay, so once the crease is cut, I'm just gonna start mixing the Food Videos color with the Cancel color. And I'm just using the AVH A14 brush. Yes, A14, I don't know why I forget my brushes lately. So I'm just gonna start out going pretty deep into Food Videos. And then I'm just gonna mix it up with that and then apply it and then kind of go back and forth between the shades. So just taking it and doing a little mix. Video shade, and I'm just gonna apply it, and I'll try to add more of what it looks like it may mean. So I'm taking the Luxie Small Shader brush. I'm just going to go into Conspiracy and apply it to the concealer, and then I'm going to blend it with the Food Videos and Cancel shade, like to get it good and, you know, blended. And then I'll take the glitter. So getting ahead of myself. Just going to apply it. So I'm mixing these two shades together again, and I'm just going to run it onto the Conspiracy shade to blend them together. Then I'm just gonna take a little bit more of the Conspiracy shade and blend it together that way as well. I find that that helps to blend the shades pretty well with the shimmer and the matte to make them more seamless, is to go in with one and the other and then the other if needed. And I really like how it works out for me. Just taking this Luxie Small Tapered blending brush, and I'm going to just blend this out. Now I'll take a little bit more of those two shades on this brush and tap off the excess, and then just really focus it on this outer corner of the eye area and then flick it out. Now for the fun part. I'm just gonna take the BH Cosmetics number 7 brush and this Profusion Sparkling Eye Topper, and it's from the Mini Eyes Dazzle collection that came with this and the mascara, as I mentioned earlier. And I'm just going to, well, I'm actually gonna start out with using the doe foot applicator to apply it just kind of over the shimmer and the matte to blend them together and just have a little bit of a sparkle there. And then kind of bring it up to the crease. And I'm just doing a little bit. I don't want to take it too far. I'm kind of take it a little farther to the inner corner of the eye on the lid. once there's not as much on the applicator. Okay, now I'm just gonna use that number 7 brush by BH Cosmetics and just get some of this topper off of the doe foot applicator and create like a little blurry line. So what I'm gonna do is probably start right here on this inner corner towards the crease. And if it gets a little bit messy and out of the crease and onto the lid on this side, onto the shimmer, that's totally fine. Cause I want a little sparkle. When I think of holiday looks, I think of colorful, glittery, just extra. Now I'm really just gonna focus it on the outer part here where there's still that excess concealer and wing it out. So now I'm just going to add a little right where it looks like there's some missing, and it's probably just me trying to be the perfectionist about it, but I wanted to just use this. I want to try something different with these. I think I want to use like maybe a more skin toned eyeshadow, and I have it. And then like kind of wing it out and then put that all over it and then like have glittery kind of winged out. I don't know. Oh, it's doing the thing. Okay, so this is something that I want to warn you about, and this may be because I don't quite know much about Profusion. These were $3, so I don't really know if that matters, but what just happened here was when I blinked, I guess because it's drying, it got stuck and kind of lifted. So how I've kind of fixed that, but kind of thought I was messing it up, was I just put a little bit more Conspiracy down on that to kind of fill in where it looked like it had lifted, and you could see the base that we started with. And just add that a little more, and then just kind of go back over it a little bit. And I'm gonna try really, really, really hard somewhat shut so that I don't have to do that again. Like kind of let it dry down. But for $3, I felt like, you know, even if it was a miss, it would still be worth a try. I don't have many glittery toppers or anything like that, which I found some Black Model ones that I want to try. Ulta had them on sale pretty good. So I'm just taking more of this mix of the canceled shade and the food video shade, just kind of blending it over that, which is probably making more of a mess than blending, but it's all right. Just cleaned off the brush, and I'm gonna do a little mix of that again and just kind of touch here, because mixing the shades kind of makes it appear to be not wanting to stay that shade. And so where there's the blues picking up more, it's like the darker green kind of fading into the lighter green, it looks like, other than it might also be patchy. But I did what I was gonna do with what I had, so there's that, and I don't hate it. So I'm just gonna take this Morphe brush again and kind of really blend this right here out. Then I'm just gonna take that Luxie brush again and blend out the green, try to make it get as close to that as I can without blending the two. Not so bad for a cut crease that hasn't taken me 3 hours, I don't guess. Okay, so I'm gonna go and do the rest of my face and then I'll be right back. So until further notice, my skin is canceled. I decided I was gonna use a different foundation today that I've used several times and not had the problem, but my skin looks crusty. And I exfoliated yesterday, did my skincare. Like, I don't skip out on my skincare, I don't know. I think my skin's just changing and I'm gonna have to try different things. episode canceled unless again until further notice. That is my PSA for today. So to smoke out the lower lash line, I'm just gonna take the Not a Fact shade and I'm going to apply it to my waterline. And I'm just using this Morphe Definer brush, or I guess it would, yeah. And I'm gonna use some Flamin' Hot and just blend that out. Then I'm just gonna take that Luxie brush that we used for the blending out this green and blend out those shades just to diffuse them. I clean the brush beforehand. And for my inner corner highlight, I'm just gonna take this very, very well-loved old Urban Decay brush and use a little bit of Ranch and apply it for the inner corner highlight. So I'm just gonna pop on some mascara and lashes and I'll be right back. So this is the finished look. I'm surprised at how this cut crease didn't take me forever, because usually it makes my makeup take over about 3 hours, and this one didn't take nearly as long. So that made me really excited. I'll list everything that I used down below if you're interested. I'm hoping to hit 100 subscribers by the new year, or before the new year. So if you like this video and you're not yet subscribed, go on ahead and if you would like to hit that subscribe button, and I would so appreciate it. If you would like a chance to be featured in an upcoming video, then just use the hashtag SlightlyUnblended on Instagram and then you'll have a chance to be featured. Let me know down below what you'd like to see next, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.